Alright. So, the way I set the scene file, maybe it's different from yours, because I basically did some layout, and when we watch it in perspective, and camera view, I have my shot set up as, if you can see these gaps, there's shot one, then it jumps to shot two, okay, and it jumps to shot three, shot four. We went over this last class. The way I set up, you see my timeline is really clean, so I'm aiming at having the action from the comic in my shot. That's what I focus on, right? And then right now I can put in between. And as I'm always telling you, studios won't allow you to work on a whole sequence like this, because first, it's hard for editors to cut it, and second, they don't want to see motion blur flipping, especially when you render the camera like here. The motion blur is gonna show. So I'm gonna work on this shot in here, because this like one of the little shot and it connects. And before I start, I'm gonna save it as, just in case I screw up other shot, I still have a file, you know.
In the studio, we would just animate and they would do the camera stuff.
No. You have to do your own camera. In some studios, yes. Like in it depends on what kind of show you're working on. If you're doing TV cartoons, they will want you to lay out the shot. And then you lay out the shot, you do one pass of layout for your chunk of shots, and then they send it to the client says, it's okay, looks good, continue, and you work on the blocking and final. Right? And if you work in movies, they have a layout department that does the camera. Mm-hmm. And then you basically do your animation inside the camera.
Do they have the camera already when you start the animation?
In
after?
Yeah, some of them, yes. Mm-hmm. So for example, like if you work on movies, sometimes the camera's there depending on how they work the show. Sometimes we have to do our own cameras too, just like cartoons, but we don't do a whole shot, we do it like shot by shot. Okay, so for this shot, the girl is hitting him and he's doing the reaction. So I'm gonna animate. You see, if I'm doing this shot in a shot level, not sequence, I can change stuff like his legs. I won't put it to FK. Yeah, I won't put it to IK, I'll put it to FK. So let's see where it's his leg control. I remember he has some. Is that right? FK legs, yes. So, from 46 on, I want it to be FK. We don't see the legs much anyways. Let's animate her, I mean him, flying in. I'm gonna make this linear because she should be just coming in straight. This is gonna be a shorter shot too. You see, it's so slow. Let me see. Playback speed 3 times. Okay. So how long is this shot? This shot is 15 frames. So let's hit him earlier. We should animate him too. There's those kind of shot which is really fast. Okay. I'm gonna make this shot shorter. So you guys did you guys do any action and reaction shot? Like how guy punch another guy? No?
No.
Well, this is a good chance to include that because we have, you can focus on certain shots if you want. It's okay, don't feel sorry about it. Because some of you don't like the animation, and I understand. It's like if I go to school and I have to model, oh my god. It's gonna be so difficult for me.
We like your class though.
Huh?
We like your class.
Why? Oh, that's good, I wanna hear.
You wanna do why?
I force you guys to do homework, and I give you shit when you don't hand in your work too. Animation is kind of hard because it's not just one still model. You have to look at a lot of frames before and after. You see, so if you want to create good impact, for example, let me see, how do I put it? So right now he's contacting, we should find a right moment, right? See, that's the contact, boom. We should do something like this. Before the contact frame, we should maybe have the head go a little bit straighter, like he doesn't realize what's going on. So we'd be like that. Getting ready, and then once you got hit, boom, you should find something that snaps, for example, like the head. And then the follow through, you don't want the COG to go so fast. You want to break things like bring the chest back a little bit, bring the COG back a little bit. The head could be dragging like this, so it feels the impact. Okay, other things you can do. For example, like the shoulder. Well, first of all, we don't want to block the action with his hand, so let's get his hand out of the way. Like there, there's no shit. Bam, there's the impact. You want to start dragging. You know what I mean? Like, aha, come out. So I'm not going to push you hard, okay? He's not going to get into injury. But if I push him from here, boom, his hand would be like dragging. So this is how you want to perform the impact. Understand? Like if I push him, then his head, because this is the force going in, right? His head would be delayed, so it would be like, can you push me? Like that kind of moment. That's what you want to animate. Oh, too bad I can't film this. It would be nice if I can film this. It would be very helpful. So before the contact, we want to push him a little bit forward. Now, the other thing I want to look at is his path, Raphael's path. Let's go to visualize, create editable motion trail. Bam, now we see it. Coming straight in. Our shot is from 46 to 55. Okay, so maybe at the beginning he should be just anticipating. You see, for short like this short, he shouldn't be moving so fast in just a couple frames. Things we can do to sell the impact is animating the shoulder like this. Bam. And the shoulder comes up, go forward. See, Raphael's path is pretty important. sell the head butt moment, I'm gonna tilt his chest up like this. There. Drag the head a couple more frames because this feels too snappy. And then his hand will do something like this. Same as the other hand. For the Raphael, I probably would have curled his back a little bit. Again, because it's so short, there's not much to do. See, his head is so big, I don't want to block his view, so let's just rotate his arm out a little bit. Okay, I'm going to call this blocking. Let's see, if I have to animate this, what else do I have to animate? His head, his face, his facial. So obviously they were negotiating and it didn't look good. So he's kind of grumpy. When we do grumpy, we want to show some teeth like this. You know how it is, right? It's cartoon, you know? Mm-hmm. Now, because you see from this angle, we don't see a teeth, so pull down the lower lip a little bit. It's cartoon, so we can do whatever. Make sure he's not so happy. There. Right now he seems looking up too much. So I want to ask you, when you watch this, what do you think I should improve on? I'll put this over here. When we watch this turtle in here, what I can improve on? I feel like his head is too straight. It's like locked straight right now. Maybe he can do something like a little bit tilting, right? So when you pull your characters, you try, you know, even if it looks good on the first sight, just try something like that, or like that. Just see if you can get a different feeling, you know? Let's see if I can close his eyes. Huh? Oh, do you want perspective? You want to see the perspective? Sometimes you just can't see it all. God, how do I close his eyes?
I saw somewhere there is a blink.
Huh?
There's a blink control somewhere in there. It's not for the
where?
I don't know.
I'm looking for a blade too.
Is it on the
eyeball?
Channel block eyeballs.
Select this guy on the channel block, I don't see it. Oh, I see it.
Yay!
Alright, thank you. So like, oh, what the hell? Oh. I feel like I grew up from the 80s, and I have a lot of action figures from my grandpa. He buy me new figures every time we go out. And I play with, you know, sound effects a lot, like, oh, he's getting punched, boom, you know, that kind of thing. I don't know if you do that anymore, because you guys are so young.
Does it help with enemy?
Huh?
Does it help with enemy?
Yeah, it does. For real. I pose the character like it's in the cartoon. Yeah. And I always break the joints, because it was very fragile, right? Especially the legs, the hip part.
Yeah.
The G.I. Joe, man, it was so fun. I always try to tell students, it is, animating should be like you're playing action figures in the computer.
Yeah.
But sometimes it's hard to understand. You see these fingers? It would sell a lot. You'd be like, man, just open it. Let's play blast this, let's take a look. Oh, let me see. I just want to try blocking out each shot today, and hopefully next week I can final this little sequence. You feel the impact, right?
Yeah.
It feels like the turtle stops a little bit too abrupt, so maybe I can add something to it. You know why? After he hits, bam, the whole shell is like floating. Space, so it would be nice to add something like that's good, and then at the moment, like it's starting to come down, right? His legs would be something like there. See? It's so easy. One shot done. I'm gonna save this as shot 4 so I can animate him stumbling back.
Mark, I have a question.
Yes.
So could this already stick purely to the storyboard of the brains?
Yes.
Because for this example, if it is a big jump, would you animate the in between?
No, you have to animate how he jumps and attack the same shot. The storyboard is giving you that idea, this is how he wants it.
Yeah. But like would I just say which angle?
What do you mean?
Like would I make the jump in this frame?
Oh, you do the punch in the next shot, in this shot, you do a punch in here. You can anticipate in between shots. You could be like, you block, right? Try to block shot, bam, and you can ride up, whoa, and cut to the next shot, boom, finish the punch. You know what I'm saying? Does it make sense to you?
I wonder if it's just like confusing, is like, he's on the ground, but this is like so high. It's hard to picture.
So, like Sean. So I'm gonna set the same key. Set the camera. Just try to have the same action. Alright, and then his legs would be back to IK because it's landing. So let's see how we do this. I'm gonna cheat a little bit. Yeah, just to bring it back so we get more room. Alright, so he can hold here for a little bit. There, and then land. See how I transform this? Watch this, okay? Headbutt, bam. You start to roll. There, hold a little bit. When he's holding, you can start squashing his legs up. Yeah. But there's a problem with the knee. Should fix it. He can just land in a couple frames. Don't worry about Leonardo right now because he's gonna kind of walk backwards for a couple steps. After we pose him, you see what's the problem? He's too straight, so give him some attitude. So let's just take a look at this guy. $46 to $75. hold it for a little bit. You see, like right now I'm doing the blocking. I don't want to say a lot of keys, I should say. I want to maybe hold this moment for a little longer. Bam. And then land, maybe a little slower. Okay, so now what I can do is start to offset stuff. Maybe have his one leg landing first. And the other leg could land a little later. Now we see two beats, bam. Okay, and then the COG, after it comes in, what we should do? We should do some overshoot. Yeah. Cool, man. Okay, so upper body. See, there's a little bounce. I think that's well.
Are you doing that kind of like that little like subtle things? Do you think about it, or is it like muscle memory?
Yeah, I just do it because I see this a lot, and I know I'm gonna do it. So, if you have that eye, then you just do it, you know. But if you're not sure about your posing, then don't do it. Because I'm pretty sure about my posing right now, and I just offset it no matter what. Or else I suck at this and I can't teach you. I wish someone can edit all my audio from the class. Okay, so what's missing? His arms could be offset too. I didn't teach the previous time for like these kind of things because it was different. Remember, Mitch? It was about shots. It was about parkour and how you use path animation and all that.
Yeah. Path animation was kind of interesting.
Yeah, but I think they should do this first. This gives them a better sense of storyboard and how to do shots together as a sequence level.
What is path animation?
It's like, it's not really like just path animation, it's a mix of. For example, like when you animate Iron Man, right? You can't just animate him through space because then the keys are like in a huge value. So we draw a path, parent him on a path. But then there's also offsets, how you should position his COG, for example. Because it's not coming out from the COG anymore, right? When he's flying, it's the chest that is leading. So you have to do a whole another level of constraints. I'll teach you guys later on. Yeah. After we've done this, when you guys have a better understanding of shot. Oh, look at this, so nice. Right? I think it's okay. Okay, that's animated Leonardo. You see, when I animate these kind of shots, I have to act it out too. Look at the scene. Okay, so his right leg is in the front. So if it's me getting hit, I'll be like, boom. So slide a little bit, and then left and then right. You see, when I do sliding, I click all these translate values together. And then you can offset these legs, just translate him forward a little bit to feel that there's a sense of dragging. If you can't feel it, then I'm going to push it down a touch, like that. You don't want it to feel like that he's on ice, so this distance have to be, you have to do it a couple times just to get a sense of dragging. So one quick step. And then you're gonna say like, oh, it's out of frame. So don't worry, we're gonna fix the camera too. When we look at this graph, you see why it's not working? Because the tangent, there's a slow in. When we look at the translate set, there's a slow in the previous shot, this should be not slowing in, and this should be not slowing in either, right? Because it should hook up. So now, that should be better. Do you understand why I break the tangent? Because the action should be like fast in right away. Sometimes when you do constraints, this matters too. See, I can animate him up a little bit. grow?
Yes.
No, no, because I thought, never mind.
I worry about it, man. You intrude my class. He asked if I'm having a class. I said, do you think I'm here for fun? Alright, so let's talk about adjusting the camera. For this first shot, I would have the camera. Let's look at the perspective. I would have the camera rolling a little bit like this. And so we see how he pushed. If we use a tongue, for example, as a target, we can see that now Leonardo is more in the center of the frame. Once he hit, boom, right? So this action kind of follows through to the next shot. Right, so they're now a little bit too far apart. So that this kind of transition would be good, but we're gonna make sure again these are linear. So let's play glass these two shots, take a look. See, his steps looks kind of clumsy, Leonardo. Could do a little better. Huh?
His hands keep on moving
too. Oh, thanks for giving me notes, man. I'll give you notes, man, don't worry. You see what I can do better? I can put his leg closer so it doesn't just drag in. Translates that. kind of see a little art, and here, I'm gonna animate his upper chest a little bit. It's a little soft like spaghetti. I'm gonna make it a little faster. I think that's good. Okay, let's see. See, I didn't animate the other's hat too. It's a little soft in the shot. So now I'm gonna speed it up just because. Select the whole thing. Set it here. See if this is gonna work. See, if you're not very good at Maya, you shouldn't scale the keys, okay? I was very stubborn when I first started animating. I don't want to scale the timeline because it makes it really messy and hard to clean up. Nah, the old way is better. Maybe it's the speed from the COG, so let's see. Yeah, you see how slow it is? This is kind of fast. So this is pretty fast. Let's hit it. Shot five. Where's shot five? Where's shot 5.1? Let's blast you. Okay, so he anticipated, probably winding up his right, and then he goes in the air at the end of the shot. Okay, so let's do this. So, because he is like a Superman speed, I'll do the fly in 4 frames. 4 is kind of too slow anyway. Let's try 2. Well, let's try 4. Just like that. So how do we make this look better? Let's line up a little bit here. I would line up his chest a little bit so the chest can lead the action. Alright, let's take a look how the anime is had. Let's try this. You feel the sense that he's charging, right? And then to the next shot. Wow, I'm so fast. Damn it, yes. Are you guys done yet? Because some of you are not watching, right? So you must be faster. He actually punched her. Oh man, it's so difficult. Let's try it. Again, this is going to be really short. Because it's so short, I'm just gonna make it linear. Whoa, look at this. Whoa, poof. Poof. Let's try to animate this camera. I will do this double cut. Double cut means you see the punch in the first shot, then you see it again in the second shot. And the timing of a punch usually is 2 frames. Good. Next shot. This is what I'm gonna do. I like this pose. So, because this is at the beginning of the shot, so I'm going to do this. And double cut means... you see the action twice, back to back. I hope it looks okay. Let's take a look. Sometimes when you're animating and you're lost, just try to animate the shot that you have a feeling on. If it makes things easy, you don't have to start from shot one, you know. Yep, the third shot has to go a little longer.